One day, if the surface of the Earth became uninhabitable, if we could no longer see the sun, feel the wind, and kept the sky only in our memories, if humanity had to take shelter underground to survive, what would we need? First, air. Without breath, nothing else matters. We would need systems that produce oxygen below the surface. Perhaps enormous algae farms, millions of photosynthesizing algae inside glass tubes casting a green glow through the tunnels. Perhaps artificial leaf technology, machines that convert carbon dioxide into oxygen with special panels that mimic sunlight. In short, even in the heart of darkness, we would have to build living factories. Then, water. Life underground can only exist where there is water. We would collect the droplets seeping through the rock in vast reservoirs with filtration and purification centers and pipes that carry every gathered drop to the city. People might forget the sound of rain falling from the sky, yet find peace in the murmur of underground waterfalls. Food would be our greatest test. Imagine subterranean greenhouses, white artificial lights instead of the sun, vast fields of LEDs. Vegetables, fruits, and mushrooms would grow beneath those lights. For protein, we would produce cultivated meats, insect farms, or engineered seafood. To live underground, we would have to bring nature down with us. But a human being cannot live on a full stomach alone. We would need light, because our spirits cannot endure endless darkness. In underground cities, we would create an artificial sky with giant projectors. Maybe stars would be set into the ceilings with LEDs. Maybe holograms would revive sunrise and sunset. Children would run under that artificial sky. Elders would sit in its gentle daylight. That light would allow not only sight, but existence. Another need, space and order. We cannot remain cramped in narrow tunnels. There would be tiered grand halls and plazas, layers linked by escalators and lifts. We would be forced to build underground metropolises, homes, markets, schools, hospitals, each reconstructed within the dark stone. And what about energy? An underground city depends on a reliable, enduring power source. Geothermal systems would draw heat from the depths of the earth into the city. Nuclear microreactors, perhaps kilometers below, would run quietly, supporting a civilization. Everything would depend on electricity, lights, agriculture, air systems, water pumps. If we lost power, our city would become a tomb of darkness. Yet beyond all of this, we need one another. People living underground would have to be more connected than ever. In tight spaces, conflict is easy. Cooperation becomes essential. Art, music, and theater would be reborn because living without nourishing the soul is impossible. Perhaps murals would appear on cavern walls. Perhaps holographic concerts would be held. Perhaps poetry would illuminate the darkness from within.